Now, I was back in the office the other day, and I was praying and seeking the Lord and everything, and I looked up over my wall there, and I remember when I first started pastoring, I think it was 1998, I believe, what the Sister Banger, something like that.
Yeah.
And two friends of mine was real close to us and everything, and they give me this. I'm going to Sister Andy get a good picture of it. That's called the Billy Mass. And I love that song, and I'm going to preach this morning on Don't Worry, Be Happy. Amen. And I want you to listen to this.
Don't worry. Be happy.
Don't worry. Be happy. That's my kind of fishing. Amen. They knew I liked the bass fishing and everything, so they got that for me. But it has an impact, and it has something it says there. And I tell you, the words on top has a great impact. And that had a great impact. You know, every time I kind of feel discouraged or something, I just push that button. And it says, don't worry, be happy. And the Bible tells us now in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8. Now, church, we're going to have troubled times. And even Job said, every man that's born of every person born of a woman is going to have troubles and trials and everything. Now, Paul, and then he kind of brought some of these troubles out. That's what it says now in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8. We are troubled on every side. Now, I'm glad he didn't say I was troubled. It says we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Now, we can bear witness of these times and things. And so Paul says we're going to have trouble because it's on every side. Let's bow our head. Father God, we thank you, Lord, this morning for every song, every testimony. Thank you, Lord, for your Sunday school, Lord. And thank you for those that are here this morning, Father. Lord, we know that we have a lot of that is sick, Lord, and traveling, Father. But God, we pray for those that are here, Lord, that you will touch them and minister to them, Lord. And Lord, let us not be worried and troubled at all times, Father. But God, let us be happy, Father. God, we can be happy at any time that we, all the time that we're in. Because, God, we are saved. We're on our way to heaven, Father. We've got, Lord, somebody with us that will go all the way with us, Father. Lord, we pray, God, for those who are not here this morning, that you will also touch them and minister to them, Father. Lift them up. Now, Father, whatever thing we say, everything we do, Lord. And, Lord, I pray for that anointing, Lord, that you give your ministers, Father, and touch them hearts and lives you hear. And, Lord, give them the anointing, God, that they can hear and understand as well, Father. And, God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your presence, Father. And, God, we give you the glory and the honor and the praise for everything that you're doing, everything that you're about to do. And, God, touch those ears, Lord, and minds, or listen to, Lord, this message this morning, Father, in your name. Everybody says, amen. Now, church, we have a right. We can say that we don't have to, amen, to worry. We can be happy. It's because, number one, the Bible says Jesus is with us. Now, I know we're going to have trouble. Paul said we're going to have trouble. Paul said we're going to have persecution. We're going to have all these things, amen, in this life. That's why we got Jesus, amen, because the Bible said, Jesus said, I will be with you always, even until the ends of the world. So, church, when we're going through these troubled times, when we're having sickness and having heartaches and having disappointments and walking through the valleys and having the afflictions and things are upon us, we can still, amen, be happy because we know that Jesus is with us. And when Jesus is with us, I think everything is going to be all right because he's going to make everything right anyway. Because when we are weak, he is our strength. And when we're walking in sorrow and everything, he is our peace and he's our comfort because he is with us. So we can be happy this morning and not be worrisome this morning when we're going through something because we know, amen, that Jesus is with us. But church, not only that, we can be happy this morning and not be troubled and everything and be worried about everything, because you know what, church? I'm looking for Jesus to come back. Now the Bible says Jesus, we're going to live with Jesus and we're going to reign with Jesus. Now Jesus went through all kinds of persecution. He was our example. But church, I want you to know something this morning. We are going to live with Him. And we've got that promise this morning. Like Paul said, we're troubled on every side. We're distressed, but we're not relaxed. We're despaired, but not persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, amen. But all these things that we go through with, Paul recognized when he went through these things, he said, I will one day live with Jesus. Now, I know Jesus lived and reigned with us, but one day we're going to live with Jesus. And that should cause us to be happy this morning, just to know him, that one day we're going to live with him. The Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 8. But he said, but let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for the helmet, the hope of salvation. See, we can have hope this morning because we know that we have Jesus in this life as well as the next life to come. But church, we've got to hope this morning because one day we're going to live with Jesus and we're going to be out of all these things that we're going through as we walk through this life. Now, this is what it says. It says, for verse 9, for God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. Wherefore, comfort yourself and edify one another, even as, also as you do. So this is my job, and this is your job, that we encourage and amen each and one of us, and edify the Lord Jesus Christ, and lift him up, and lift one another up, because church, one day we're going to live with Jesus. I'm looking for that day, church, amen. And the older I get, amen, I believe the sweeter it's going to get. Like that song says, heaven gets sweeter every day. Why? It's because we know that we're getting closer and closer, man, to live with Jesus. And not only we're going to live with Jesus and reign with him, not about you, but I've got loved ones up there. I've got a mom and dad, brothers and sisters and all these other loved ones and friends up there just waiting to meet us on the other side. What a day that's going to be, churches. So just like that little Billy Bass song says, don't worry, just be happy. And church, let me tell you, I'm happy this morning. And church, we can be happy this morning because you know why? Jesus is with us and we're going to live with him and we're going to reign with him. So we can have, amen, the blessings of God upon us because whatever we're going through with, Jesus is with us. Can I hear an amen? Praise God.
Amen.
And not only that, but the Bible says that, you know what? We may not be worth a lot then in this life. In fact, the Bible, and I think God knows that. But you know what, church? One thing about the Bible says, amen, that we're worth more than all the sparrows. Now, God said they recognize that even a little sparrow, amen, that falls to the ground. Bible said even though when the sparrow falls to the ground, God knows about it. But he said we are more worthy than all those sparrows. Why? Because if he could look at a little thing like a sparrow and recognize it, amen, you know what? He said we're more worthy than all those sparrows. That means, church, we are precious in the eyes of God. So, church, we can be happy this morning, amen, because even though we may be have troubles, we may have worries, but we can lay them to the side knowing, amen, that we can be happy because we are worth something. We are worth many more than the sparrows. Look what it says. First of all, the Bible says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, but my God shall supply all your need according to the riches of glory by Christ Jesus. Now to God our Father be glory forever and ever. Amen. In other words, what Jesus said there is, amen, he's going to supply all of our needs. What if that need may be? We may need a miracle. We may need a financial help. We may need a lot of things. But the Bible says he's there to meet our need. Why? Because we are worthy, and he wants us to let us know. If I recognize a little sparrow and recognize how precious they are into his eyes, then we are more precious than that because we are in the image of him. I mean, church, well, he made us in the image of him, and therefore we are precious. He gave us a free will, amen, that we can love him and worship him and praise him and glorify him. So therefore, we need to recognize I am worthy. And like I song says, amen, I'm a child of the King, you are a child of the King, and thank God he took us from a, amen, from a nobody and made us a somebody, because we are a child of the King, and church, we are worthy of God to praise him and to glorify him, because church, he says, you are worth more than all the silver and all the gold. You're worth more than all the sparrows, because they're precious. You are more precious than all these things. And that's why he loves us this morning. Amen. And that's why I love him this morning.
Amen.
The Bible says in Luke chapter 12, verse 6, as are not five sparrows sold for two farthings, and not one of them is forgotten. See, God is not happy. He didn't save us and made us and forget about us. He said, I don't even forget about the little sparrows. Amen. That's what it said. It said, are not five sparrows sold for two feathers, or father, and not one of them is forgotten before God. But even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, you are more than value than many sparrows. So he said, we're worth more than many sparrows, church. We are worthy this morning. God has made us to be worthy, and therefore, church, that we are precious in his eyes. So when we're going through things, Paul says, I was persecuted. He said, I was in despair. He said, I'm forsaken, cast down, but not destroyed. Why? Because we're precious in the eyes of God. And church, when the devil tries coming and knocking at your door and trying to put things in your mind that God doesn't love you and God doesn't care anything about you, and he does, because the Bible says we are precious in his sight. So therefore, when things happen, don't worry. Just be happy, because we are a child of the King and we're precious in the eyes of God, and he's going to take care of us. Can I hear an amen? I thank God this morning we are precious in his sight and we don't have to worry. In fact, the Bible tells us, let not your heart be troubled. Why? Because, church, let me tell you something. God says that we're precious in his eyes. And church, he made us to be his jewels. And church, we ought to worship him and praise him. Even with it, like a song says, amen, this is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice. And why be glad? Because, church, we are precious in the eyes of God, and he's going to take care of us. I don't care what we're going through with or what we may go through with. God says you are precious, and church, if we're precious, we are precious in his eyes because his word says so. And I think I stand on what God says. And I'll give him the glory. How about giving him a hand clap this morning? Praise God, because he's worthy to be praised. Glory to God. But you know what God asks us to do? He just asks us to seek him. You know why? Because he wants to supply us everything. That's why we can be happy when things are not going our way. He just said, just seek my face and turn to me, and I will supply everything. I will take care of you, because you are precious in my sight. The Bible says in Luke chapter 12, verse 31, that said, but rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added to ye. Fear not, little flock, for this is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. See, God, we're so precious that God says, I am going to give you my kingdom. And church, let me tell you something. We read about Revelation. We read about the new heaven and new earth and all these things that God has in store for us. And God wants us to inherit these things and enjoy these things. And one day we will, church. And that's why we can be happy. It's because when we go through these things, we recognize that we're precious in the sight of God. And God has great things in store for us. We just got to hang on, be patient, and love him until the very end. And the Bible says, patience possesses thy soul. Why? It's because we know the good things that we're waiting for, and we've got some good things waiting for us. We just got to seek the kingdom and hang on to him, because it's God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. Glory to God.
Amen.
I'm here to tell you, we got good things going our way. And we don't have to worry. I know sometimes we have a tendency to worry. That's why Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. St. John chapter 14, verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. Why? If you believe in God, believe also in me. Thank God we got Jesus, amen, with us today. And he'll be with us, amen, tomorrow. And he'll be with us at the end of the world, because the Bible said that we are most miserable if we just have Jesus in this life. But we've got Jesus in the next life. So we've got promise and we've got hope that Jesus lived with us, and he'll never leave us nor forsake us in this life or the next life to come if we'll just hang on to him. Can I hear an amen? See, God takes control of everything. He is in control. He gave us life, and he's not coming to give you life and life more abundantly. We just got to hang on to him, and when troubles come, just let's just be happy, amen, and not worry about things. When I first got saved, I had a tendency to worry, and I had to deal with that. Some of us, we all have to. And the devil wrote me and everything because I was always worried about, amen, living for God tomorrow. And church finally come to me. God spoke to me and said, you know what? Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow may never come. You just don't worry about serving me today. Tomorrow will take care of itself. And finally, he got this in my spirit and everything, and I started serving Jesus one day at a time. You just serve Jesus one day at a time, and don't worry about tomorrow. And church, you don't have to worry because Jesus will take care of us today, and tomorrow if he comes, he'll take care of us tomorrow, because he's the same God today, and he'll be the same God tomorrow. He'll never leave us. And church, he said, I promise you that you will live with me. I'm looking forward to live with him, church. Amen. How about you? Glory to God. The Bible tells us, amen, we've got a future. We've got a future, and we shouldn't have to worry about what's going to happen in this whole world. Now, church, we went through tribulation, revelation, everything, and God gave us a foresight of everything that's going to happen. I know we're going to have the love of many is going to fall away. I know we're going to have perilous times and troubles and many kind of afflictions and everything. Because, let me tell you, the world is not going to get no better until Jesus comes back. It's going to get worse and worse and worse. And church, all we've got to recognize is that we don't have to worry about all these things, because we have looked in the back of the book today and we saw the new heaven. We saw the new people. We saw that new river flowing down. We saw all the new things that God is going to give us. So therefore, we don't have to worry about this old world, because the world is going to take care of itself, because God is going to see that. But we've got a promise, amen, that we have a future, that one day we're going to live and reign with Jesus, and we're not going to have no more cloudy days. I know we're going to have death. We're going to have heartaches. We're going to have tears. We're going to have pain. We're going to have separation and all these things, because God has promised that, because the world is full of sin, and sin is still ruling everything. But thank God, one day sin is no longer going to rule. The devil is no longer going to rule, because God is going to take everything and make everything new. And so we've got a future this morning. It will just hang on to Jesus. Amen. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
The Bible tells us in Job chapter 19, verse 25. Now, let me tell you something. Man, Job suffered back in the Old Testament time. Now, there was no man probably didn't suffer like Job did, as far as the Bible gives us. For the Bible says he wrote that down with a pen, that we could have understanding and see the patience and the love that Job had for God. The Bible says in Job 19, verse 25, he said, "For I know that my Redeemer lives." So, church, we've got to recognize that Jesus lived. Now, I know he died. He said, "I was dead, but now I'm alive, and I reign forever." So, Job recognized that his Redeemer is going to live. He said, "I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though my skin worm destroy this body, yet in my flesh I shall see God." Now, church, that is faith. He didn't have the spirit like we had. He didn't have the word like we have. He didn't have the revelation of things that we have. And like I said this morning, we as a church, we can see that from Genesis, from Revelation. In fact, we can see Genesis all the way to the end of Revelation, the things that God has in store for his people. And that we know that we've got a future, church. And I thank God that we do have a hope. We have a lively hope that we have a future this morning. Amen. That Jesus lives. And because Jesus lives, we can live. And because he's going to reign, we're going to reign with him forever and ever. So we have a future. And he said, "I know my Redeemer liveth." We got to know that our Redeemer, Jesus Christ, lives. And because he lives, we're going to live. And one day he's going to stand up upon the earth. And glory to God, we're going to see all his glory. And we're going to be part of his glory. Praise God. Now the Bible says in verse 27, "Whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall see, and shall behold, and not another, that my reins be consumed within me." In other words, no man has ever seen God. We've never seen God. Even the Bible said we haven't ever seen Jesus, but the Bible said even though we haven't seen Jesus, we still love him, and love is appearing. So Job hadn't really seen the glory of God like one day we're going to see him, but he knew that he was alive. He knew that there was a God. He knew that one day he was going to stand up and he was going to see him for who he was, because his body was going to be changed like our body was going to be changed. So church, we have a future this morning that we're going to live and reign with Jesus and worship God. Lord, give the Lord a hand clap this morning. Praise God. I love that song, and I know sometimes the church gets angry if I sing it a lot about the new Jerusalem coming down. And I tell you, I'm looking for that great day. You feel why? Because you and I are going to be part of it, and we're going to be that future. It's going to happen, church, and the Bible says it's a cube. It's 1,500 miles long, 1,500 miles wide, 1,500 miles deep. It's a perfect cube. And what I love about it, the Bible says there is room for everybody. Everybody that wants to go to heaven, everybody that wants to be part of it, you can be part of New Jerusalem. You can be part of God's plan. And church, with all the things that we go through with, don't worry about it. Amen. Just be happy that you're a child of God. Amen. That Jesus is about to come back, and he's living with us right now. And one day we're going to reign and rule with him. And we're going to a place where there's no tears, no more heartaches, no more trials, no more troubles. And God is going to dwell with us. Glory to God. I'm about to get happy now. I'm looking for that day. How about you? Are you looking for that day that Jesus is going to come back and we're going to go home to be with him? I'll give the Lord a hand clap, church. It's going to happen. Like what Billy Nash says, don't worry, don't worry. Just be happy. Let us be happy with what God is doing for us. Let us stand this morning. Glory to God.